गुड इवनिंग एवरी वन, माई नेम इज़ तनु। आई एम स्टूडेंट ऑफ बीएससी केमिस्ट्री ऑनर फाइनल ईयर। टुडे आई विल रीड द टॉपिक ऑफ इनऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री फॉर विजुअली इम्पेयर स्टूडेंट एंड माई टुडे टॉपिक इज यूज ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक एंड इनऑर्गेनिक रिएजेंट इन इनऑर्गेनिक एनालिसिस। इंट्रोडक्शन। रिएजेंट आर दोज कंपाउंड विच आर यूज इन ऑर्गेनिक एनालिसिस फॉर द डिटेक्शन एंड डिटोनेशन ऑफ आयन एंड मोलिक्यूल। ए लार्ज नंबर ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक एज वेल एज इनऑर्गेनिक रिएजेंट हैव बीन यूज फॉर दिस पर्पज। द इनऑर्गेनिक प्रेसिपिटेटिंग रिएजेंट जनरली प्रेसिपिटेट द इनऑर्गेनिक स्पीसीज एज स्पंजली सोल्यूबल साल्ट ऑफ हाइड्रस ऑक्साइड। द ऑर्गेनिक प्रेसिपिटेटिंग एजेंट फ्रॉम स्पंजली सोल्यूबल प्रोडक्ट आइदर थ्रो कोऑर्डिनेट लिंकेज और थ्रो आयनिक लिंकेज बिटवीन द इनऑर्गेनिक स्पीसीज एंड द ऑर्गेनिक प्रेसिपिटेटिंग रिएजेंट। एडवांटेजेस ऑफ यूजिंग ऑर्गेनिक रिएजेंट। द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ यूजिंग ऑर्गेनिक रिएजेंट आर लिस्टेड बिलो। The first one is there are more specific than conventional reagent under certain condition. Because of this property, they can frequently be used to detect a single type of ion or in a complex mixture. They can be more sensitive. Classical semi-micro method of a quantitative analysis with usually no detach much less than 100 gammas of a substance under specific test solution. Organic reagent on the other hand are capable of detecting below 10 alpha R and in certain cases as little as 10 की पावर माइनस थ्री गामा। थर्ड पॉइंट, दे कैन बी अडोप्टेड इन क्वांटिटेटिव एनालिसिस। द ऑर्गेनिक प्रेसिपिटेट आर जनरली इनसोल्युबल इन वाटर एट ए गिवन पीएच एंड कैन बी सेपरेटेड ड्राइड एंड फेड। दोज रिएक्शन गिव कलर सोल्युबल प्रोडक्ट फ्रीक्वेंटली सो इरेगुलर चेंज इन कलर इंटेंसिटी विद कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ द सब्सटेंस अंडर टेस्ट एंड सो आर अडोप्टेबल टू एन एक्यूरेट कंप्रेशन विद कलर रिप्रेजेंटिंग कंसंट्रेशन। दिस इज द बेसिक आइडिया ऑफ द ब्रांच ऑफ कोलोरोमीटर। कॉमन प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक रिएजेंट। सम ऑफ द कॉमन प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक रिएजेंट ड्यू टू विच दीज आर यूज एज ऑर्गेनिक एनालिसिस आर गिवन बिलो। फर्स्ट वन इज फॉर्मेशन ऑफ कलर्ड प्रेसिपिटेट। ऑर्गेनिक रिएजेंट फ्रॉम डायरेक्ट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक कलर्स विद द आयन टू बी डिटेक्टिव वी फॉर लोकेटिंग एंड पॉइंट दैट इज एज इंडिकेटर इंप्लॉयड इन वॉल्यूमेट्रिक ट्रांजिशन। द सेकेंड पॉइंट, फॉर्मेशन ऑफ प्रेसिपिटेट ड्यू टू डिफरेंस इन सोलिबिलिटी। दिस मे बी मे नोड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ ए ग्रामेट्रिक मेथड। थर्ड पॉइंट, एक्सट्रैक्टिंग इनऑर्गेनिक सोलवेंट एज कंट्रोल्ड पीएच। फोर्थ, मास्किंग reagent. These increase the selectivity of a reagent. Fifth, difference in volatility. Sixth, oxidation reduction to other valency state. Seventh, wash liquid. The chemical nature of the organic reagent is important in determining the use of mentioned property. Advantage of organic reagent over inorganic reagent. It is due to the following property that they are better precipitant reagent than inorganic reagent. Selectivity. In many cases, organic reagent are somewhat specific. For example, cobalt from nickel using alpha nitroso beta naphthol or dimethyl gloxime. Aluminium food, iron using cupriform, cadmium from copper using quinolidic acid and thiourea can be precipitated. In some cases, adjustment of the pH will often cause precipitation of one constituent alone. By changing pH and solvent condition, one constituent after another can sometime be quickly precipitated out. Second is of drying. Organic reagent produce compounds that have little affinity for water and are dried easily at temperature low enough to prevent decomposition. Third point, co-precipitation. Lack of ionic character of organic precipitant product greatly reduce co-precipitation in most cases. For example, the co-precipitation of sodium and potassium with magnesium is much less than with the latter is precipitated by 8-hydroxyquinolone than which is precipitated by phosphate or oxalate. Some exception in metal do occur. It has been little studied, but in case it is as bad as an organic precipitate. Reagent are usually insoluble in water. Therefore, it is important not to add an excess reagent. This is difficult because there is no way to tell which when sufficient reagent without excess has been added. Any excess that is insoluble would add to the weight of the precipitate. Disadvantage of organic reagent. These are unfortunately disadvantage to using organic reagent volatility. This is the first practical disadvantage of organic reagent because chelated compound are non-polar. The focus between individual molecule in the crystal are not very great. Thus, some of the metallic complex which are precipitated in analytic chemistry are appreciable volatile about 130 to 150 degrees Celsius and most decompose about this temperature. Therefore, and the drying of precipitate should be done below 130 degrees Celsius to avoid decomposition. Second point is impurity in reagent. It is very difficult to prepare an organic reagent of the same degree of purity as say inorganic compound. Impurity present in organic reagent may enter into the precipitate during the preparation and cause undesirable reaction. For example, a point dimethyl gloxime exists in three forms: alpha, beta, gamma. Of these, only the alpha form is specific for nickel. While preparing dimethyl gloxime
alpha gamma foam is also formed with the alpha foam. It is the precipitation is carried out with the impure dimethyl gloxamine. The nickel will be precipitated with some other metal because alpha foam is specific for nickel, whereas gamma foam can precipitate other metal also. B. Ketoenol isomerism is such compound as diethiojoin, which cause error in colorimetric work unless condition are carefully selected. Third point, low solubility of the reagent in water. This is the greatest disadvantage which organic precipitate have in comparison with inorganic precipitate. High molecular weight, the very high molecular weight of the chelate complex formed with metal ion reduce proportionality, small error in precipitation and weighing. Fifth, colored compound. Chelate compound are often highly colored, and since they are usually soluble in organic solvent, they lend themselves to colorimetry or photometric method of analysis. Six, soluble in organic solvent because of their covalent nature. Most metal complex with organic reagent are soluble in non-polar solvent, chlorophane being usually the best. Such solvent are used to extract the complex for colorimetric determination, or they may be used simply for separating one element from another. Thus, the complex of cupferone with dry positive iron is very soluble in ether and chloroform, which allow one to remove a large amount of iron from solution containing a aluminum. In this extraction, the pH must be careful adjusted to give the desired separation. Important organic reagents. Some of the organic reagents which are generally used in the identification of iron are discussed below. The first one is oxime C9H7ON. The structure of this reagent is given in figure 18.1. It is almost a colorless solid, soluble in organic solvent and mineral acid. It gives a yellow color, which may be due to the formation of a cunoid structure. It was introduced by Hahn and Berg in 1927 as an analytic reagent. A number of metals give coordination complexes with the reagent. Examples of such metals are magnesium, zinc, copper, cadmium, lead, aluminum, iron, bismuth, gallium, thorium, zirconium, etc. The formation of the complex compound with a bivalent metal ion like zinc is shown as below. The quantitative estimation of the complex is carried out by drying and weighing the hydrated or anhydrous complex or complex designated to oxide and then weighing. In volumetric method, the precipitate is dissolved by filtering with hydrochloric acid and then resulting solution is titrated against standard potassium bromate bromide solution. In spectrophotometric method, the estimation of the metal ion is carried out by measuring the optical density of the complex. The reagent has been found to be suitable for magnesium, aluminum, etc. The reagent is a 2% of the solution of oxime into an acetic acid, dimethylglyoxime. This reagent was described by L. Tegnérgaff and was applied by O. Brunch 1907 for the determination of nickel in steel. The structure of the reagent is shown in figure 18.2. This reagent gives an insoluble red chelate with nickel ion in ammonical medium. For detail our application of the formation of chelate complex discussed in chapter 2 on basic constant of coordination chemistry. Chapter 1, solution of palladium salt give characteristic yellow precipitate in dilute HCl or H2O sulfur, but nitrate ion interfere. Solution of bismuth salt also give a yellow precipitate in presence of aridity at pH 11 to 11.15. for the study, 1% solution of the dimethyl gloxamine in alcohol is employed. In separation in spectrophotometric method, the insoluble precipitate is extracted into chloroform, which yield yellow color, and then the optical density is measured. Third, alpha nitroso or beta naphthol, also called 1-nitroso 2-naphthol. The structure of this reagent is shown as A of figure 18.3. It is an orange brown powder having melting point of 109 degrees Celsius, soluble in organic solvent but almost insoluble in water. The reagent is usually employed as a saturated solution in 50% acetic acid. This reagent is common for the precipitation of many metallic radicals, but it is used especially for the detection of ferric ion, copper and cobalt with palladium and uranyl salt in slightly acid solution. It gives soluble colored compound under stable condition. Nickel and magnesium, however, are not precipitated by this reagent. Therefore, the reagent in acidic solution is used for the separation of nickel from cobalt. The structure of the chelate complex formed by the reagent with cobalt 3 ions is shown B of figure 18.3. The reagent has also been used for the spectrophotometric determination of cobalt and a few other metal ions. It is also used for spot test of cobalt. Cupferone. Cupferone exists largely not in the nitroso hydroxy form A, but in tautomeric amine oxide form B, A, figure 18.4. The reagent is usually employed as a 6% aqueous solution, but it is most useful in strongly acidic solution. In strongly acidic solution, it precipitates Fe3C3 NbNTaW6Ga, gallium and SN2Cu2 etc. precipitate should be filtered immediately after their formation. Become cupferin is not very stable in acidic solution. Further, more precipitation should be carried out in cold since the reagent is decomposed into nitrobenzene on heating. The precipitate cannot be weighed after drying but must be ligninated to the corresponding oxide and then weighed. The formation of chloride complex with Cu2 positive ion can be shown as follow. Fifth one is aluminum. It is an ammonium salt of iron trihydroxylic acid. Its structure is shown in figure 18.5. It is a brownish red color, freely soluble in water. It forms brilliant colored lakes with certain metals, especially aluminum, with which it gives bright end lake. Aluminum is a dye and it is very important reagent for spectrophotometric determination of aluminum. By adjusting pH of the test solution below 7.8, it is possible to estimate 0.005 mg of aluminum even in the presence of calcium. The reagent is prepared by dissolving 0.1 gram of the substance in 100 ml of water. Sixth one is rubenic acid, also called dithioxamide. This reagent is the diamide of dithioxide. Acid is an equilibrium mixture with its tautomeric and diimido form. The aqueous form combined with nickel, cobalt and copper to give colored water insoluble in a complex salt whose composition is shown in figure 18.6. The copper, cobalt and nickel compound are quantitatively precipitated from strongly ammonical solution in strong mineral and acid solution. Rubenic acid react only with certain element of platinum salt. In addition to ammo, rubenic acid from colored compound with silver, mercury, bismuth and iron. Rubenic acid is not only a spot test reagent but also as a gravimetric spectrophotometric reagent. Rhodamine B, it is tetraethyl rhodamine and is present by the structure of given in figure 18.7. Solution of antimony salt is strong hydrochloric acid react with rhodamine and the aqueous solution of the reagent changes from red to violet or blue and finally divided precipitate separately immediately. Or after standing, trace amount of antimony may be detected in the presence of large quantity of tin. By means of this reagent, small amount of iron do not interfere. Mercury, gold, platinum and precipitate while molybdates and tungstate in acid solution give color. Reaction with rhodamine B similar to those given by antimony salt. The freshly prepared benzene solution of rhodamine B is the preferred to the aqueous solution benzidine. Its structure given in the margin in figure 18.8, it is a basic reagent and it is employed in slightly acidic solution as dihydrochloride for the precipitation of sulfates as C12H12 and 2S22 positive SO42 negative. The resulting precipitate may be titrated against standard alkali. The important drawback of this method is the relative high solubility of the precipitate in water and even more in dilute hydrochloric acid. It also precipitate anion like phosphate and tungstate and give crystalline precipitate with a number of metallic ions such as silver, copper, cadmium, gold, zinc, etc. with CO and TiN benzyldW coloration in alkali medium, which is an important spot test for metal ion. Recently, benzidine in dilute acetic acid has also been employed as a spot test reagent for the identification of some platinum metal like osmium, iridium, and platinum, cupferin, or alpha benzoin. Its structure is given in figure 18.9. It is a white crystalline solid. It is potentially soluble in water but fairly soluble in alcohol. It also exists in isophoric beta form cupferin. Cupferin is used as reagent for the quantitative determination of copper, molybdenum and tungsten. Alcoholic solution of cupferin give a green precipitate with ammonical solution of copper salt. Precipitation of other metal in ammonical medium is prevented. In the presence of tartaric acid, the green precipitate is soluble in dilute mineral acid. Copper can be estimated both volumetric and gravimetrically by the reagent. The green precipitate is an inner complex whose formation can be shown as cupferin also precipitate molybdenum and vanadium ion quantitatively, but in strongly acid solution, vanadium give a yellow color precipitate while molybdenum give a white precipitate. Tungstate and palladium also appear to quantitative precipitate with alpha benzoin oxime. Figure 80AL aluminium has recommended the use of the agent for the detection of slightly soluble materials such as Al2O3 and BaCO3 etc. Magnesium. The structure of the reagent is given in figure 18.10. It is also called para nitrobenzene azo resorcinol. 1 to 0.5% solution in 0.25 N in NaOH is generally employed in In alkaline solution, it forms a bright blue lake with magnesium, and the sensitivity of this test is influenced by the presence of ammonium salt, so their presence must be avoided. 11th, alizarin S. It is alizarin sulfonic acid whose structure has been shown in figure 18.11. It is a dye whose sodium salt is soluble in water and it is employed as an analytic reagent. Aluminium salt gives a red precipitate with the boiled solution of alizarin S in ammonia. This complex is an adsorption complex of aluminium with alizarin sulfonic acid. Adsorption system of this type containing metal hydroxide and a dye stuff are called lakes. Zirconium 4 form red violet colored compound with the reagent under the alkaline condition. Boric acid also forms brilliant red color in UV light by alizarin NH2SO4. The reagent has been employed as a spectrophotometric reagent for the above metal ion as well as few other. Furthermore, it is applicable as adsorption indicator as the titration of FeCN6 for negative and MOO42 negative has also been reported. Nitrogen 12. Its structure is given in figure 18.12. It is yellow solid. It is insoluble in water but dissolve in acetic acid. It's 10% solution in 5% acetic acid, generally used as a reagent. Nitrogen use nitrate. Yield Sprengel soluble fluorine nitrate C20H16 and 4HNO3 in solution acidify with acetic or sulfuric acid. Thus nitrogen is a gravimetric reagent for nitrate. Perchlorate, perhenate, tetrafluorate and tungstate also form insoluble salt and can be determined in a similar manner. Numerous other anion including bromide, hydride, chlorate, thiocyanate, nitrate and chromate interfere but may easily be removed by a preliminary treatment. The result is the presence of chloride ions are generally high, possible because of co-precipitation. Thank you.